Call them, spam them.
We're gonna get started in like 2 minutes, but you know, like Miss Saturday was saying, if you wanna reach out to your friends and invite them, you're more than welcome to do that. And we got some superstars in the house. You know, we see some people that are a part of the actual open mic here. So we got some superstars. It's always incredible how, like, you know, you watch something, like you watch like LeBron James or somebody on TV, and then you see them in person and you're like, oh my God, that's really them. That's how I feel today with some of you. Some of you have submitted some fantastic work. I'm looking at you like you're superstars. So I'm just really impressed. You know, some of my leadership team was able to watch it in our meetings, the videos that you submitted. You know, hopefully your families can, you know, tune in as well. But it's going to be an amazing event, and we can't wait to show off all your work. So we're just going to give it a couple minutes until we actually start. But we definitely got to give a big shout out, you know, to Saradi. So Saradi, you know, we thank you so much for all the work that you put into, you know, putting together this masterful production. I know it took a lot of time, and the kids, after they see it, they're going to be forever grateful. You know, I'm definitely grateful of all the work that you've done. Any words, Saturday?
I'm looking forward to just sharing all of this, like the experience of the showcase with you guys. I was really excited when I was watching and editing all of these. So I know everyone else will be really excited. I'm looking at you, Elsie and Mina and Alejandro. And I think that's everyone that I know that is in this open mic. So you guys are really talented. So I'm really excited.
Yeah, you all rock. You know, just so you know, we are going to have a raffle, right? Because some of you are here just for the raffle, which is sad, but we're going to have a raffle. And Sean and Jolay will announce the winner. So we're going to put you on a spin wheel. And then we're going to announce the winner at the end. So stay tuned for the raffle at the end. And we're going to have a $25 gift card of your choice, I believe I said, to either Amazon or Grubhub. And we'll send that over to you via email so you can take care of that. But we got to go over some rules. So as you may notice, you're not able to unmute yourselves. You know, we just don't want to have any incident of any type of disrespect at all. So we're going to have a lot of, you know, great performances. So we just want to make sure that there's no misinterpretation. So you're not going to be unmuted until you're called upon. So only the kids that are going to introduce their work will be able to be unmuted, and then you can speak, you know, less than a minute about your work, and then we're going to transition into the actual performance. And the way we're going to do it, we're going to put the YouTube link, because we got it all in together. So like everybody that has a performance is all together in one, and we have it on YouTube. So we're going to put the link in the chat, and you get to have a watch party with us. We're also going to share it here on Zoom, but you know how sometimes Zoom is a little laggy? You can listen to Zoom and watch the videos on YouTube, so it could just be perfectly high quality. So you don't miss anything. There's no lagging, and we're all on the same page. When we ask you to pause, you're going to pause. Our gracious host for today is going to be Ms. Jolay. Ms. Jolay is going to take it over in a second, and she's going to guide you through the entire performance. But again, I have to make sure that everybody understands the way we're going to celebrate everybody is through our reactions. So after every performance, you're going to go to reactions. You're just going to make sure that you're saying thank you for all the hard work that each and every one of the performers did. So we're going to have virtual reactions. Also want to talk about our third cycle. You all know Friday registration goes live. We're going to send out the sign up genius. And if you want esports, if you want debate, you want Fit Factory, if you want any of these classes, you got to sign up right away. You cannot wait, because we switch up the Zoom link. So if you're in debate now and you think, hey, I'm going to just be in debate again, that's not the case. We're going to have different Zoom links. There's going to be different kids in the class. So you have to register early. Always register early. Okay. I got out the rules. We talked about the third cycle, which happens on March 5th. The actual cycle of the third cycle starts March 15th. But now, without any further ado, I'm going to pass over to Ms. Jolay. Jolay, take it away.
Okay, thank you, Tracy, and thank you all for coming. This is an amazing event, and we have some super stellar stars going to show us some pieces of their work, or, you know, whatever they're presenting today. So the first one up is Miss Jillian. So if you could unmute yourself and just tell a little bit about what you're going to do, and then we're ready.
Hello, everyone. Can everyone hear me loud and clear? Give me a thumbs up if you can hear my gorgeous, gorgeous voice. Oh, thank you. Thank you. I come to you today by wearing the world's most beautiful blouse. And I come to you today, not just wearing a beautiful blouse, but with a beautiful song in my heart. So, you know, I'm famous at SONYC for, you know, dabbling in the art of improv and theater and comedy, all the trinity of beautiful things in this life. And I am just jonesing to do some improv right now, right here, right now on this Zoom with the coolest students on earth. So I am going to, you know, I'm feeling very generous, and I'm going to perform some songs inspired by the very people in this call right now. So I would love, all I really need to create a song, and I'll give you a couple of little ditties, you know, if I have it in me. I see some thumbs ups. So I would love if someone could type in the chat, someone give me the name of an animal you would find in a jungle, and someone type their favorite food, and I'll see what sticks, and then we'll figure out what the song's gonna be about. So I see monkey waffles. Okay, I'm gonna give a couple more. These are great. I love it. Orangutan. Oh my god, amazing. Spaghetti bird. Oh my gosh, the chat is popping off. Oh my gosh, the comments. Pizza. Okay, now I'm popping off. Okay, I think that's perfect. Thank you guys so much. I love what I see. I wanna see what's kind of sticking to me. And someone doesn't have a favorite food. Don't worry, you're young. You'll find one soon. All right. Okay, so this is going to be a song all about, a bird. A bird who loves pizza. And the song will begin right now. Well, once did you know there was a bird? Everyone wants to know. The bird was hungry. The bird was cruel. The bird just felt like a big old fool. All the bird wanted was to get a slice, hang out with some friends, play some cards, play some dice. But what the bird didn't really have to know is that everyone there just had to go to Pizza Hut, to Domino's, to Little Caesars. No one knows that the bird found the pizza slice that was the best, and it's ham and pineapple. You know the rest. Thank you. That was this beautiful song about a bird who loves pizza. And that actually just went number one on the Billboard chart. I just got word. It actually just kind of topped the charts. I would love to do one more. Thank you so much. Oh my gosh. People are saying in the comments, perfect. Never seen anyone better. Oh my gosh. Ariana Grande who? Whoa, you guys, that is so nice. Whoa. Okay. I'd love to do just one more if we have time. It's actually amazing to watch just silent, like people like, it's great, because I know you're cackling. Okay, this one, let's make a song. Can someone give me a holiday that like is a holiday that no one really like remembers? Like a holiday that's not like the, you know, the most popular one. Give me, oh, okay. Someone said Arbor Day and I'm already into that. Someone give me a holiday, and then can someone give me, the name, just like a family member, like brother, sister, cousin, whatever. Oh, awesome. Okay. Oh, I like, okay, Lorraine. Okay, perfect. Okay, perfect. So I gave you a little update, a little upbeat. I'm gonna bring this one down. I'm gonna close this out on a ballad. Kind of showcase more of my golden pipes. All right, so this one's gonna be, it's gonna have to be about Arbor Day. Thank you so much for jumping in with Arbor Day. That's famously one of the most forgotten holidays. Arbor Day, and this is gonna be about someone named, it's gotta be Lorraine. All right. Here we go. Ooh, it was a night in September, I think that's when Arbor Day is. I don't really know anything but my name. And you know my name's Lorraine. Arbor Day doesn't feel good when you're sitting out in the rain. I'm Lorraine, and it's Arbor Day, and I'm hanging out with my favorite friends because everyone knows that SONYC programming at CSS is the only thing that I can think about. I'm Lorraine, who cares about Arbor Day when you're in SONYC programming at CSS on Zoom? Todd Bye. A lot of people like Talia, like Yara, like Sean, like Jolie, like Sarai, like Tracy, like Jillian. Who could forget her name? Cause it's not. Say it with me, Lorraine. Thank you.
I gotta give a round of applause, Jolie. I gotta give a round of applause for Jillian. You know, we talked about staff having $25 gift cards. You definitely earned that gift card. I know that's not what you were here for, but that was amazing.
It's I do it for the boxes that say Evan's iPhone, that say Kayla Gerald in all caps. I do it for that. I do it for Audrey. I do it for you guys. So thank you.
I do have to say too, if you want to see, you know, Jillian in action and be a part of her classes, she actually is a part of our comedy club. So we have a comedy club class. So if you want to be a part of it, you know, definitely check her out. I'll actually share it on screen so you know when to sign up for it. But that was amazing. If I was one of you, I would definitely want to sign up for that class. I'm not gonna lie, that was amazing. So she's going to be with comedy club from 4:30 to 5:30 on Fridays. So if you want to see her in action, if you want to learn from her and do the same type of skits, not as good. Please join us for Comedy Club on Fridays. Back to you, Jolie.
Yeah, you guys, you rocked it all. Come hang out. Woo!
Thank you so much, Jillian. That was awesome. And so next, I will be posting the YouTube video in the chat right now. And so I'm also going to be sharing my screen at the same time. We're going to go through all the acts in the video together. But just so that way there's no lag on your part, you all can click on this YouTube link and actually watch the video yourself. So I will share my screen.
I just love this kind of discussion we're having about Arbor Day in the chat while this is happening. Yeah, apparently it's about trees. Who knew?
Okay, can everybody see my screen? Okay, great. And so the first piece we're going to be looking at is a skit from your very own SONYC staff. So we decided to come up with a funny skit about what a homework room used to be like for us in the building. So this is a trip down memory lane.
Okay, everyone, welcome to homework room. Come on in. All the homework is written on the board. Thank you, Lucas. Thank you, Jaden. All right, I'm gonna be taking attendance. Everybody quiet down.
Gray text box at the bottom.
If you hear my voice, clap once. I said, hello? Hear my voice, clap once. Clap twice. Clap three times. If you all don't settle down, I'm calling Miss Jolie. How you doing?
Hi, Char.
Can you come here?
Yeah. I hear your background. I'm on my way.
Yeah. I'll go in and
voice clap twice. Students, it's too loud for a homework room. Why does it take for me to come down to this class for you all to be quiet? This is the level of quiet it needs to be all the time, not just when I step in. Now we need to reset the room.
Nah, you're good.
Okay, Claudia, but we are resetting the classroom and you're a part of the class.
But what's the point though? Like, you like wasting so much time.
Just do it, please. You're making this easy process more challenging for everyone.
I have an idea. What if we reset by getting under the desks?
But like, who asked you, Ariella?
Okay, Claudia, this isn't up for discussion and I'm not gonna argue with you. If you don't wanna participate, then you'll have to be sent to the OSS or the dean and I'll just have to call your mom.
I'm not worried. All my mom's gonna do is take away my games. You think I'm scared?
Ooh, she's gonna call your mom. Why would you intentionally put yourself in that position? I love my Fortnite and Among Us. Hashtag, that gave me life.
Hello, dije. I told y'all you won't get it. Y'all don't listen.
Okay, I have your mom on the phone and I told her about your behavior. You can either talk to her in front of everyone or outside the class.
You actually called her? Oh my God, I was kidding.
Hashtag facts, hashtag chaos. Miss Julie is not for play play. Hashtag where is the lie?
I don't know. Where is the lie?
Yes, I did. I asked you to reset with the rest of the class and you didn't want to, so I called your mom.
Yo, bro, I'm so waste something. Leave me alone.
You two, Ariella, please get from under the desk. Okay, Char, take it away. Let me know if you need anything.
Jolie, don't leave.
Oh, okay.
Want to go to the bathroom.
Okay, Ariella, you can go to the bathroom, but when you come back, I expect for you to stay in your desk and not under it. Thank you.
Okay, class. Come on. Let's try this again. Come on in.
All right. Yes, that was our skit. Thank you. Thank you all. Shout out to Miss Kiara, Miss Claudia. Who else is yes, Miss Char, who I don't think is here right now. And yeah, it was fun. It was, and Miss Ariella, yeah, she's not here right now, but it was fun. Thank you all for giving me your reactions. I appreciate it. And please do not try this when we go back in person, because it'll be the same result.
Jolie, can I ask something real quick?
Sure.
What a great job, Jolie. Shout out to you and the team. That was amazing. But just also remember too, you do not have to watch our screen share, right? That's the reason why we put it on YouTube. You can watch YouTube as we're watching it so you can see it clearly and the lag doesn't happen. So what I think you should do is just click on the link that we have. We could probably reshare it again, Jolie, just in case. And what we want you to do is click on it so you can have that, you can have the screen up, you can have YouTube up, but still listen to us on Zoom so we can tell you when to pause it so we can come back to Zoom. So watch it on YouTube, but come back to us on Zoom so we can continue to narrate what we're gonna do.
Just a quick question. Did anyone else see a gray text box on the video? Or was it just me?
Yeah
everyone
that
did.
I don't think
that was me. It's me looking at the chat. So that's the Yeah, that's the gray.
Okay, that makes sense. All right. I can also share it if you want from my side. And I don't, if you're gonna be using the chat, since you're the host, I think people are gonna send you messages, but.
Okay. Yeah, that's fine then. All right, so then next up on our list, we have a performance from Mina.
So
could we also reshare the link some people are asking in the chat?
Yes, I will do that. Okay, so Mina, if you want to show, well, tell us a little bit about your performance. Let me unmute you.
I'm gonna play piano by, I'm gonna play piano, and the song I will be playing is called Around Midnight. It's a jazz piece composed by Wes Montgomery. Basically, originally, my dad introduced me to the song because he really loves Wes Montgomery's music playing. He's like, oh, you should like really learn to play this. So I asked my piano teacher, and she's like, yeah, sure, we can learn. And I soon then realized how, like, what an emotional piece it was, and like how, like, breathtaking it was to, like, play it and hear it. So, I submitted it.
Okay, thank you so much, Mina. Sarai, you can share the screen now.
Everyone can see it, right? It looks good?
Yes.
Yeah? Okay.
All right, everyone, give it up for Mina. Yes, that was such a powerful and beautiful piece, Mina. Thank you so much. I had no idea you even played piano. So that was awesome. Yes, yes, clap it up for Mina. Okay, so next we have Gabriella. Gabriella is not here right now. So Sarai, you can just play the video.
I saw it again the other day.
Just give me a second, sorry.
Hello, this is the poem I made a while ago in my notebook. When I'm sad, I hide, and my fear consumes me, and my eyes leak. I hide under the bed and take chances to cherish under the dimming light. Light or dark, it seems like the dark is better with my friend. Everyone might have someone's time to spend. Listen to its calls and walk away from it all, but love your spirit because you might feel a tether one day. Another poem I have is called Camp Crawley. At the wooden cry of a bird, so in need of a night, don't think this is absurd. I call your name and name in sight. I see a path, a star so bright. When you held my hand at moon, I hoped again I would see you soon.
Another poem I have is called The Call. A call that I heard a while ago still haunts me today. I saw it again the other day. It haunted me again, and I don't know why. We're bonded together like a tie, a bow. I don't know. We stay together forever, undying, undenying, immortal, and I don't know how to get rid of it. Maybe I just need to let it stay. We need to talk. I need to talk. Leaves are everywhere. Literal, metaphorical, poetic. The kinds you see in your mind that make you daydream and makes your head float. The kinds that you see on the ground in the autumn and watch them drift away during the winter. And kinds that you see everywhere. Kinds that you might see drifting through the office while you work, making you think about what you're doing. Making you think if I'm doing something wrong. Leaves are everywhere and they make you think. They're important.
All right, that was Gabriella's. She wasn't here. But yes. Yes,
snaps for Gabriella. Okay, and then the next piece we have after that is by Elsie.
Yes.
Elsie, you are here. If you can, I'll unmute you, but if you want, you can talk a little bit about your piece or you can write it in the chat.
It's just a little kind of trailer of Binti Sacrifier of my project for ELA. I'm not going to use it for the project, so I just put it there.
All right, thank you so much, Elsie.
First things first, I'ma say all the words inside my head. I'm fired up and tired of the way that things have been. Oh, ooh, the way that things have been. Oh, ooh. Second thing, second, don't you tell me what you think that I can be. I'm the one at the sail. I'm the master of my sea. Oh, ooh, the master of my sea. Oh, ooh.
In the evening, I would sit outside behind a lute. That's my Siamese hat. I'd be wearing my long skirt over my legs, and I'd remember my hands to the sound. It was cool on the surface, but underneath it was warm. That body is living. And here I am, at Windsor University. I am Binti Ekapara Suzu Dambu Kepa of Namib, and I'm a harmonizer.
Great job, Elsie. Thank you so much. That was such an amazing piece. And I love the song. Every time that song plays, it just does something to me. I love it.
Can I just comment on Elsie? That was amazing. The video editing was so great. You're going places. This is awesome.
Yeah, any other staff members, you can go as well.
I loved it. Thank you so much. It was so inspirational and beautifully done. So thank you.
I'm just obsessed with that editing. It was really good.
I love the images and also the music you put with the images. So many messages that when we look at it again, we'll probably see something new. So thank you so much.
Yes, thank you so much, Elsie. The next person to present is Lily. I don't think Lily is here right now, so Sarai, you can go ahead and play the piece.
Ho, ho, it's magic, you know. Never believe it's not so. It's magic, you know. Never believe it's not so. never been away. Never seen a daybreak. Meaning on my pillow in the morning. Crazy game band. Music in my head. Crazy music playing in the morning light. Oh, 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 it's magic. You know, never believe it's not so. It's magic, you know. Never believe it's not so. I love my sunny day, dreaming far away, dreaming on my pillow in the morning. Never been away, never seen a daybreak. Sleeping on my pillow in the morning light. Oh, 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 it's magic, you know. Never believe it's not so. It's magic, you know. Never believe it's not so.
Cute. Everybody give a round of applause for Lily. Jillian, I think you got some competition.
I know, like coming from my gig, but I mean, I would be honored to have it taken by Lily. I'm obsessed.
Amazing. Yes, yes. Another round of applause for Lily. And the next presentation on the list is Juliet.
Hello, my...
Just give me a second. I think I moved it too far.
Hello, my name is... Julia Carson, and today I will be talking about inspirational figures in STEM. So for hundreds of years, diversity has been excluded from the STEM field and privileged in white men. And thankfully, this has started to change today, and women and people of color are finally getting integrated in this field of study. So my goal is to expand our idea of diverse and include people in STEM from all over the world. So here are just a few people that are inspirational figures in STEM that have amazing stories and incredible outcomes. After this video, please feel free to visit my website and take a closer look at these people, and you could see videos and read the full description of these people. So this is Samara Mehta. She is a 10-year-old entrepreneur that designed a coding board game at the age of 7. So only at 7, Samara combined her love of coding and board games together to make a game called Coder Bunnies, teaching the players all the basic needs for coding to more advanced concepts. And her goal is to inspire underprivileged kids to code by teaching them coding by a young age so that they view this as a possible profession in the future. The next person that we have is Kelvin or dirty. And he's an 18-year-old boy that taught himself how to produce a car. This car that you could see over here was made with only scrap metal. So Kelvin lives in Ghana, which you could see on this map, is in Africa here. And he built a car from scrap. And when I say scrap, I mean nothing. He literally took the metal from like dumpsters and the garbages and magically turned these parts into a full working car. So his story is really touching, and it teaches us that it doesn't matter where you are now, but only where you go from there. So his car is really incredible, and it works like a full working car, and it's pretty incredible. Finally, I'm going to talk about Kimberly Lee. She replaced real fish with artificial fish made from seaweed, but with all the same nutrients. So today we take food for granted because we have lots of it. But unconsciously, we are sometimes destroying entire ecosystems of wildlife. So what she does is she takes a natural way of making food, seaweed, and she turns it into food. And this food has exactly the same taste, visual, and nutrients as the original natural food. So this is a glimpse of the food of the future. So thank you so much for watching this video, and don't hesitate to visit this website of inspirational STEM figures that are really just incredible, and I've attached videos so that you guys could see it. I'll drop the link in. Hopefully you guys will get the link, and see you around.
Hello, my name is Alejandra.
Hey, everybody give a round of applause to Juliet. That was amazing. She took her time to actually do an inspirational piece about STEM figures across the world. So somebody that comes from the STEM field, I appreciate that so much. Thank you, Juliet, for that. And yes, much snaps, much claps, everything. Also remember to look at the YouTube link. It is in the chat, and to make sure you are named as your student first and last name, okay? We have an amazing raffle coming up. So if I don't know what the student first and last name is, you won't be able to be in there. Next on the list is Alejandro. Yes, so let me unmute you so that way you can talk about your piece.
My piece was originally meant for Black History Month, the Black History Month showcase, but I didn't submit it in time. So I just decided to do it here. I really like the rock genre and the heavy metal genre, so it's like a rock song. It's about like white supremacy and racism, and I hope you like it.
Thank you so much, Alejandro.
This is a song that I wrote about racism and white supremacy. I initially meant to do it for the Black History Month showcase, but I didn't submit it in time, so I'm gonna do it for this, the open mic. We need to justify those who died this whole time. We've been living lies. White supremacy is not a game. And unless we start doing, everything will stay the same. White supremacy is a game, and it's not. We need to justify those who died this whole time. We've been living lies. White supremacy is not a game. And unless we start doing everything, we'll stay the same.
Give it up for Alejandro using his voice. Thank you so much. Yes, it was amazing. Thank you so much. And whoever did that video editing that shifted over to the sign that said Black Lives Matter, that was a really important part. Thank you so much, Alejandro. Oh, that was your mom? Okay, shout out to Alejandro's mom. Okay, and then the next person is Joe Zimne. Joe isn't here, so you can go ahead and share, Sarai.
My name is Joseph Ney, and I'm going to be reciting the poem Caged Bird by Maya Angelou. A free bird leaps on the back of the wind and floats downstream till the current ends and dips his wing in the orange sun rays and dares to claim the sky. But a bird that stalks down his narrow cage can seldom see through his bars of rage. His wings are clipped and his feet are tied. So he opens his throat to sing. And Cagebird sings with a fearful trill of things unknown but longed for still. And his tune is heard on the distant hill, for the caged bird sings of freedom. The free bird thinks of another breeze and the tree winds soft through the sighing trees. And the fat worms waiting on the dawn bright lawn, and he names the sky his own. But a caged bird stands on the grave of dreams. His shadow shouts on a nightmare scream. His wings are clipped and his feet are tied, so he opens his throat to sing. The caged bird sings with a fearful trill, things unknown but longed for still. And his tune is heard on a distant hill, for the caged bird sings for freedom. Thank you.
Snaps for Joe. Everybody give snaps for Joe. Yes, and shout out to Sarai, who decided to put in the videos and the pictures of the birds to enhance Joe's piece. It made it all the more better.
Thank you. Oh, that was, yeah, Joe also just did a wonderful job, and also Gabriella. So fitting, finding imagery to like pair it up with it was really fun and amazing. We have our last person now. It's Finnegan. So yes. He's also not here, sadly. So, all right. So I will share it now. And yeah, please enjoy. This is a great piece. Everyone's piece has been great.
Hello, welcome back. We have a human fighting a turtle live. Witness says it was none other than our host, John McTurtle. Wait, I'm John McTurtle. I just gave a confession. It's our new host, Leonardo DiCaprio.
If he doesn't be a part of production one day, like, he's doing a disservice to everyone. That was amazing. Yes, so thank you to all of our acts. Thank you for everyone for being here. I believe I can give it to Miss Sean for some closing statements, and then we will do our raffle.
Yes, thank you all for being here. You know, just another round of applause, snaps, you know, or reaction buttons. And thank you all for participating, either submitting videos or acting live in person, or and just being here to support your fellow peers. This was so fun. And I was so pleased that, like, the diversity of things that we got from people. You know, you sometimes with these things, I expect, like, you know, 4 piano pieces and like a few acting gigs, but this was so interesting. I think everyone has creative ideas of what they could consider an open mic presentation, you know, so this was really exciting. You know, hopefully in our future, there may be another one of these. We might, you know, in a different iteration, just so more of you guys can show off your talents and unique skills that you have. And because we love learning these things about you. So Jolay, I think we'll spin the proverbial raffle wheel and we will announce the winner. And then we will release you for the evening. If you want to stick around and hear the winner, might be you. You can react in person, you know. Like, oh my gosh, I'm so pleased.
Okay, I will share my screen and let's see. I put everyone's name in. So remember, if I didn't see a student's name in there, I just-
That suspense is killing me.
All right, here we go. Josephine! Woo! Josephine is the winner!
I'm obsessed.
$25 gift card.
Congratulations. It should arrive in your inbox soon. Let us know Amazon v Grub versus Grubhub. You know, you have a choice in the matter. Whichever you use more frequently or like more. Oh, Josephine, I was saying you can do you want me to type it in the chat?
Yeah, you can type it in the chat.
Oh yeah. So you won the raffle. We'll we'll send out to you. You can decide if you want to do, or if you want to tell us now, Grubhub versus Amazon, but you can expect that in a few days from these from any direct email to you. But congratulations and thank you.
Yes, any other staff members have anything to close us out? Thank you all for coming.
Never stop performing what everyone did today. Keep on doing it. Keep on doing it. I'm serious.
Keep those creative juices flowing. Like, you all did really amazing things today that had very powerful meanings. And I'm just so glad that we were able to showcase a bit of that. And we hope to see you guys again participating in these events and hopefully encourage other people to participate too.
And I just want to I just wanted to echo everyone, just keep creating. I was blown away by all of your varying talents, your burgeoning interests, like all of that. You know, share this with your family, share it with your friends. It's a link, it's on YouTube. Share it with everyone that you know you want to. You deserve the recognition for the amount of work that you put into making this and for being here and for supporting each other. And that is the essence of creating and creative projects. So continue to build, continue to talk to each other, connect and create some more stuff. And hopefully we have another open mic because I think this has been like one of my favorite events personally. So hopefully if you share this video, it'll hype it up and we can have a second one and, you know, we can have even more people out here and maybe more submissions as well. So great job, everyone.
Also, just thank you for sharing with us, right? For many of you, I didn't even know. Okay, so many wonderful talents and also so many powerful messages as well. Not only did you showcase your creativity, but you also showcased your brilliance and your passion for various issues in this world. So thank you so much for your inspiration.
Yes, thank you everyone. I think that is the end. So we're going to wrap it up. Have a great night and we will see you all either later in another event or in electives tomorrow.
Bye.
Bye.